गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज मंजू सिंह फ्रॉम शांतिनिकेतन जुबलर स्कूल मोतिहारी। दिस इज द रिवीजन वीडियो ऑफ फर्स्ट चैप्टर ज्योग्राफी ऑफ क्लास 10th। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट लैंड एंड इट्स डेवलप लैंड एंड इट्स डेवलपमेंट, हाउ लैंड इज डिग्रेडिंग। इन दिस विल स्टडी सम अदर टॉपिक्स लाइक रिसोर्स प्लानिंग। रिसोर्स प्लानिंग इज कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस, वेरी डिफिकल्ट प्रोसेस इन इंडिया। वाई इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट प्रोसेस इन इंडिया? बिकॉज फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट वी हैव टू सर्वे। सर्वेइंग इज डन ऑल ओवर द कंट्री वेयर रिसोर्सेज आर टू बी फाउंड। तो सर्वेइंग इज वेरी टाइम टेकिंग, टाइम कंज्यूमिंग प्रोसेस। देन मैपिंग इज डन, मीन्स हियर दिस टाइप ऑफ resources are found, and after that it is seen that we are having technology or not. If we are having technology, then we can use them. If we are not having technology, we leave them as reserve. Next thing is that now after doing all these things, we see whether the resources are economically feasible or not, means the resources which we have found, they are costly or not. If they are costly, then also they are left as reserve. But if they are not so costly, if we are able to afford them, then we use them. But at the same time, it is also seen that the resources which are not feasible, means which are very costly, but it is very important for the nation, then what happens? It is used. So that is why it is called difficult or complex process, because lots of things are done before the use of our natural resources. Now we'll come to soil. What is soil? It is called a living process. Soil is a living process. How? Why? Soil is renewable source. How soil is renewable? Because soil is renewed, it is made by breaking off, weathering away of the rocks every time. But making of soil a few centimeter of thick soil takes millions and millions of years. But what happens, what we do, we destroy the soil within minute. So soil is called living process because it is always being made. And another thing is, soil is a resource. Soil is resource. As we have discussed, that what is resource? Resource are all those things which are used to fulfill our needs. The soil supports everything. Life, human life, plant life, animal life, every economic activities which is done over the land is done over the soil also. So soil is a resource. And what is called, we are degrading soil. Some are natural factors which degrade soil, but some important human factors are there, like deforestation, means we cut the trees. And as we know that after the cutting of trees, what happens? The roots of the trees are, if the trees are cut, then what happens? Roots are not there. So if trees are there, then what happens? The roots, they hold the soil. They not let the soil erode. They not let the soil move. Then हाँ, बट वॉट एंड अनदर, एक तो फर्स्ट थिंग है कि हम लोग डिफॉरेस्टेशन करते हैं, मीन्स फॉरेस्ट को कट कर देते हैं, जिसकी वजह से सॉयल जो है वो इरोड हो जाता है, मूव हो जाता है। देन अनदर थिंग इज अनसाइंटिफिक मेथड ऑफ फार्मिंग। एज आई हैव डिस्कस दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द फार्मर्स इन आर कंट्री, दे बिकम फार्मर इन कंपल्सन, मीन्स दे डोंट वॉन्ट टू बिकम फार्मर। They become farmer when they do not get any job. So they are not very educated. They are not know the method how to farm. They do not listen the programs of the radio or television, they do as they think it is very good. They hear from here and there and they do the farming. The plowing is also not done in the very good manners because they are not skilled. And if the work which is done by skilled laborers, skilled farmers, that is very good way. Now when Green Revolution had started, since then what is happening, the people are using, farmers are using HYB seeds and fertilizers, and they do irrigation, and but still then they are not getting the amount which should get. Why? Just because the farmers are not taking full opportunity. Natural factors are also there which removes the soil, which erodes the erosion means removal. So which removes the soil, and there rainfall, water, running water means rivers, then wind, and these are named as water erosion, wind erosion. Then comes another human activity which is overgrazing, means as I had said that the causes for the land degradation are similar to the causes of the soil degradation. So what is the meaning of overgrazing? Means cattle are left to eat as much as they can. They remove the roots of the plant, they take out the plants and the roots are removed, and then what happens? The soil from that place is removed. The soil which has taken to be renewed millions and millions of years. We people, what we do, we take few seconds and few minutes to erode, remove the topsoil, which is very fertile. The topsoil is very fertile, but what we do? We remove them. And these are the soil erosion causes for the degradation and the erosion of the soil. Over the hilly areas especially, soil is eroded in sheet, means large areas. Soil is removed because hilly areas, by either by rainfall or by rivers or by wind, soil is removed in among from the large area, and this is known as sheet erosion. Removal of soil from a large area, especially over the hilly areas or slopes, is called sheet erosion. Then one is gully erosion. Gully erosion is sometimes, suppose a place, it was fit for agriculture, it was fit for everything, but rivers came, and rivers, what rivers did, the rivers cut the soil and made channels there, means nala type ka bana diya gaya hai. और वो जो सोयल है अब किसी लायक नहीं रहा, बिकॉज इट इज़ एज वाटर इज देयर, मीन्स लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर इज देयर, चैनल्स हैव बीन मेड, सो नाउ दिस सोयल इज नॉट एबल टू बी कल्टिवेशन, इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर गेटिंग कल्टिवेटेड, इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर मेकिंग हाउसेस, इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर मेकिंग रोडवेज एंड रेलवेज और फॉर एनीथिंग. So this type of land, this type of erosion, this type of removal of soil is known as gully erosion. And these channels are known as gullies. They cut soil deep by water. And these gullies are known as ravines in Chambal Basin. Means the area which is drained by river Chambal. There gully is known as ravines. Now another thing which we should do to solve this problem of soil erosion. So what should be done? First thing, there is deforestation cause for the soil degradation. So there should be afforestation, means we should plant trees. Then our method for farming should be organic, means we should use manure, we should use earthworms, we should plant jatropha, we should use rotation crops, like once you are growing paddy, then you grow pulses which make the soil fertile. We should not overuse chemical fertilizers, So for agriculture, plowing should be done in a scientific method. Then we should cultivate our field with a strip cropping. Means we should make strips. टुकड़ा एक टुकड़े पे आप एक अलग प्लांट को ग्रो करो तो दूसरे टुकड़े पे आप एक अलग प्लांट को ग्रो करें उसके, या फिर इस तरह भी आप स्ट्रिप बना सकते हैं, यहाँ पे आप एक अलग प्लांट को ग्रो करें यहाँ पे, बट ये बात ध्यान में रखना है कि जो मेन प्लांट है उसका न्यूट्रिशन दूसरा वाला प्लांट नहीं ले ले। जैसे हम लोग यहाँ पे मेज के साथ, मक्का के साथ में आलू की खेती करते हैं। फिर उसके बाद वो है शेल्टर बेल्ट को क्रिएट किया जाए, क्वांटर फार्मिंग की जाए, यानी कि जो स्पेशली हिली एरियाज होते हैं वहाँ पे सीढ़ीदार फार्मिंग की जाए। तो सीढ़ीदार मीन्स टेरेस फार्मिंग, वे फ्लैट टेरेसेस आर मेड, स्टेप्स आर मेड, एंड क्वांटर मीन्स लिटिल स्मॉलर, इट इज़ अ स्मॉल टेरेसेस विच आर नोन एज क्वांटर फार्मिंग। एंड इन क्वांटर फार्मिंग व्हाट हैपन्स, द इन बिटवीन द क्रॉप्स सॉइल इज ऑल्सो केप्ड सो दैट द plant should get nutrition from the soil. Then shelter belt, you have means I have already explained in the previous video also, sand dunes should be stabilized. So all this method which we adopt to prevent land, those methods are also adopted to prevent our soil. Now we have come to an end of the first term syllabus. Even revision has come to an end. But instead of that, if you have any question, you can ask me on my number or by comment. Thank you. Have a very, very, very good day.